Yo, what is up, squad? It's your boy Pino E here, back at it on this fan-fucking-tastic Thursday. Today's video is gonna be short and sweet, but before we get into it, smash that like button. And now let's go. Let's kick today off with Adidas and a look at the Naked Adidas Consortium Collection. The focal point of the collection is the newly designed Arkane Boost silhouette, but also includes five other items, including a denim jacket, tracksuit, crop top, and shorts. Ladies, this collection is exclusive to you, and those shoes are dope. I'm a big fan of this pair, mostly a fan of the distress look. But anyway, they drop on March 10th on the Naked website for $160. Over to Nike, and let's start with a look at the all-new Nike Air VaporMax 97, a silhouette that combines the Air Max 97 with the VaporMax outsole. This pair features a full black based upper paired up with white Nike branding sitting on top of a blacked out VaporMax Air unit. Of course, the shoe wouldn't be itself if it didn't feature the iconic 3M piping, and these do. There's no exact date for these just yet, but you could expect them sometime this month to drop as part of the Air Max Month celebration for $190 retail. Alright, so let's talk about the rumors floating around surrounding the Nike Yeezy. If you haven't seen or heard the rumors, then let me fill you in. According to some folks out there, Nike is working on reintroducing the Nike Yeezy in new colorways with a new influencer being involved in the project. I have no idea if this is going to happen or not, so I can't say if it's real or if it's fake news. I think I did mention in a video sometime last year that there were rumblings internally at Nike about retroing this pair. So if that does happen, I'm not going to say that I'm completely surprised. Obviously, if the shoe does drop, it won't be called the Yeezy since the name belongs to Kanye, but the silhouette does belong to Nike, so they could get the final say if they want to retro the model, tweak the model, introduce a whole new version. Whatever the fuck they want to do, they can because it's theirs. Regarding the influencer who will be working on the model, I've heard a few of you mention Dauncey, and holy shit do I want to see that happen. Kanye would lose his mind if Nike drops this model. I can't wait for the tweets about that, but if his bestie, BFF, buddy for life, Dauncey is involved, this shit would be golden to watch. It would be the ultimate sneaker betrayal. The blow up would be fucking epic. So I'm hoping this is true for that reason alone, but I don't think it is. Reason I don't think it is because I did hear that Nike is signing a new influencer. And whoever this influencer is, it's supposed to be huge. I've been racking my mind trying to figure this out, and I've been reaching out to some of my contacts, but so far nobody seems to be able to tell me who this new person is, so we gotta wait. In short, I don't know if these are coming out. I'd like them to, I doubt it, but I don't know enough to say yes or no either way. What do you all think? Should Nike release a retro or introduce new colorways or keep these locked in the vault? I'm petty as fuck. If I were Nike, I'd drop the shoe in a new colorway every time Adidas dropped a Yeezy, but I'm not the CEO, so I don't get a say. Anyway, leave your comments below. Let me know what you all think. Over to Jordan Brand, and let's start with the ladies' Air Jordan 1 Rebel. A couple videos ago, I gave you all a first look at the silhouette in the top 3 colorway, and today I'm here to show you all the model in a Chicago colorway, but as well let you know that the pair is dropping in shattered backboard colors as well. Okay, my thought here. The silhouette isn't bad. I think it's kind of cool for the ladies, but I also think it has more of a fashion vibe to them, and these colorways with the giant Nike Air logo on the side isn't working. The shoe itself is cool, the colorways, eh. I don't think so. But ladies, let me know your thoughts in the comments and stay tuned for release info. Next up, we got a first look at the women's Air Jordan 3 Rose Gold. We've already seen the women's exclusive Rose Gold 11 Low, and to complement that release, Jordan Brand is dropping a matching colorway on the 3 silhouette. This iteration of the Air Jordan 3 comes with a reconstructed build featuring a light pink suede upper paired with rose gold accenting and leather detailing atop a sail rubber midsole and outsole. Ladies, stay tuned because these are dropping, but we don't yet have a date. And last but not least, today we get a new look at the Air Jordan 11 Low Jeter. You might remember this pair from a few days ago, but also because its resemblance to the $40,000 mid that was limited to only 5 pairs. Really, this shoe is no different, coming in the same navy blue suede upper, same wax laces, same branding across the midfoot, and the number 2 stitched in the heel. The only difference, one is a mid and these are a low. I like them, I'm a fan of the silhouette, I'm a fan of Jeter, and the materials look dope. No idea on how limited or available these will be just yet, but you could expect them to drop sometime this April for $200. And that does it for today's video, everyone. If you enjoyed it, and I hope you did, hit that like button. If you're new around here, subscribe, join the squad. If you've got something to say, leave it in the comments below, and I'm out.